All right, Charlie. Well, you know, crews were working overnight in Columbus sandbagging the area's water was running over roads and creeks. Fire crews had to keep cars off most of the roads, saying the current could easily carry one off if they tried driving through it. Joining us now on the phone is Lieutenant Jared Fox from the Columbus Fire Department. And, Lieutenant, you know, we've heard from a couple of people in Columbus today just saying some of your roads are impassable. Is that still true?
Yeah, correct. School Street in the city of Columbus and Farnham Street are impassable yet. Farnham Street, though, the barricades are up, but they've moved them to the side. There is no water standing in that road, but there is a lot of water standing in School Street section yet. So the main arteries into Columbus are open, but you will see barricades up on some of the roads just for precautionary reasons because it is sprinkling a little bit here in town. And with the forecast, there's no sense in taking everything down and then having to rush to get them back up once the flooding starts again. The creek in town here through Columbus is very, very high. So unfortunately, any amount of rain, I have a feeling we're going to be back to the same situation we were last night.
Yeah, and that's what Charlie is predicting. You know, your crews, we're looking at video right now. Your crews stayed out overnight sandbagging, and they were telling us if you even see movement in the water, it's a current. Don't even try to drive through it.
Yeah, that's correct. Especially over by Farnham Street, the water was coming through so fast. That was the area I was in. And we actually were going to try to cross there to stop traffic on the other side, and you could just feel it rushing at your legs. And once we stopped traffic, boy, you could really see it coming right over. It looked like it made its own river over the water, over the road, over the curb, everything. So it would have easily carried a small, compact car away as fast as that was flowing.
That's frightening. And I know, Lieutenant, you are talking just about Columbus, but I think what other people say in Sun Prairie, in Watertown, in Fort Atkinson need to glean from this interview is if you see water on the streets, if there's any kind of current, don't do it. You can't predict how deep it is, even when and if the sun comes up, right?
Yeah, you're correct. And no matter how much of a hurry you're in to get to work or get your child to daycare or get somewhere, it's really not worth your safety to rush through there because, you know, the water can even erode away the dirt and stuff and take the road away if it's bad. And,
yeah.
And, boy, you just don't know what you're driving through when you get through that murky water. And especially if there's a current, you just never can tell.
I always say you never want to be permanently late. Lieutenant,
yeah, that's very true.
Lieutenant Jared Fox, you were going to say something. Hang on.
Yeah, I just wanted to give a shout-out to everybody that helped last night because it was wonderful to see at 11 o'clock your crews came down, and I got to see the shot from the sandbagging, and it wasn't only just firemen from Fall River and Columbus. It was just people that heard the flooding was going on and just jumped in and, as a community and helped out, and that was just really great to see different faces coming by and helping out their neighbors.
Well, that's very important to remember, and I've heard of several stories like that through South Central Wisconsin because everybody needs a little bit of help right now, and those sandbagging procedures can be very strenuous. Lieutenant Jared Fox with the Columbus Fire Department, we appreciate your time this morning for a very important warning, not just for Columbus residents, but for all residents that will still see more flooding today. Thank you again. Be safe.
Thank you, guys.
Well, Madison, you know, we also saw our sheriff.